Alright, so today we're going to be looking through my TikTok For You page just to see what's on there. So, here we go. Okay, so I guess we're going to rate these. I guess we'll do a couple, then we'll rate them. I'd give this one a solid 6 out of 10. It's kind of funny, it's kind of true, but other than that, it's pretty, I've seen a lot of them, so yeah, I'd give it a 6. I give it a 7, pretty original, I'd say. I don't really see that many with people playing it on instruments and stuff, but I'd give it a 7, could be better. But it's part 15, so who knows what the other ones are like. I guess if I, okay, so I'm just going to lay down. I won't be doing ads. I won't be doing the story, or I'll do the story times. But if I find a story time, I'll go and find the part so we can hear all of it. But other than that, that's all I'm doing. What was that? Whatever. Okay, here we go.
I remember when I lost my mind.
Okay, so I forgot to rate this one. This one's just reaction, so absolute disgusting. 0 out of 10.
Day 18 in a row. Got me a little horny toad lizard. Day 18 in a row.
Okay, review time. 9, 10, pretty cool. D's a troop, so I'll give him that. But the horned frog was pretty cool, so 9 out of 10, just because he's a troop. Otherwise, pretty boring. So first 15 seconds sounds absolutely horrible. I don't really know what this is. Apparently it's a tuning. See, this sounds nothing like tuning, but then again, they are one of those fancy ass bands that go around all around the country and perform against like 7 other. I think they're drum corps or something, but that's kind of weird. Okay, I rate it maybe a 7 only because it sounds absolutely horrible, but maybe I'm just uncultured to that level of band. I don't know.
Who is the greatest basketball player of all time?
Michael Jordan.
Michael Jordan.
Up and down. Up and down. Who is the greatest basketball player of all time?
Hey, so I feel it's a trick question because it's all based on opinion.
Give me an answer.
Michael Jordan.
Up and down. Future Stellar Flores. Who is the greatest basketball player of all time?
What's it called? Hold on. Wait,
I know
Petty Officer.
I know
Allen Iverson.
Up and down. Future Stellar Ryan, who is the greatest basketball player of all time?
Kobe Bryant.
Who?
Kobe Bryant.
Up and down. Who is the greatest basketball player of all time?
LeBron James.
Up and down. Who is the greatest basketball player of all time?
You, Petty Officer.
I don't play basketball. Up and down. Great answer. Who is the greatest basketball player of all time?
Petty Officer. In this Future Stellar's opinion, Wilt Chamberlain was the best basketball player.
I would have attempted to answer with a better answer. Up and down. Who is the greatest? Who is the?
So I forgot I have to rate this. Pretty cool. I would definitely say it's misleading in the description, but I give it like maybe a 7. I like these kind of trivia questions, but this is not really a trivia question. This is more of a who do you like more question. That's why I don't really care for it that much, but. Other than that, I give it a 7 out of 10, and this guy does a lot of stuff, usually relating to, you know, Navy questions, like, oh, how many buttons are on a uniform, or, oh, what was this aircraft carrier name, and what did it do, but, other than, yeah, I'd say it's a 7, probably.
Hello, my ragtime band.
Hit him. Hey, hey, you finna die, baby.
Okay, TikTok overall, I give it maybe a 7.5, 8. The joke was absolutely funny as hell. rip off. I'm gonna have to use that one. But I bet it could probably have been used a little bit better. I mean, but yeah, I will give it an 8. Solid 8.
Do Subway employees have an accent? 6-inch? Sub sauce? I'm not really sure what that is. That's not even English. Daddy? Absolute hell. Do Subway employees...
Six out of 10, I'm not even commenting on the second to last one.
Oh, no!
Elena, that's your froggy ass.
I am going to commit suicide!
2 out of 10. Original video, maybe a 7, but this is just a repost, and it's Rip Kermit, and Kermit's not even dead. This video came back in, like, 2016, so that date's not even right. I'm not sure about the birth. I think it sounds about right, but maybe 60s, maybe not 50s. I don't know. But overall, TikTok, 2 out of 10. Repost, trying to get likes, but obviously they didn't really hit that very well. So other than that, I give it a 2 out of 10. Original video, 7. Don't tell girls best friends. Don't tell girls best friends. Something good to me, I ain't afraid to catch a kiss. CVS is on me and I'm flooded out the face. Don't tell girls best friends. Okay, so I'm not a girl, as you guys know, so. But that's a pretty half-decent dress from a guy's perspective. I wouldn't go as far as all those pearls, but. Now, I don't know what the hell that cage thing was. I thought she was going to put it on and it was going to be like a big old bird cage or something, but... Six. 6 out of 10. But maybe for a girl, I don't know.
If you're not a band kid, I would keep scrolling. Alright, band kids, so you know in your band room you got your chairs, your stands, usually a piano, cubbies, birdcage lockers with all the instruments in it, your marimbas, vibraphones, your timpanis. But always remember that you have to have Dr. Beats or else you won't be able to function during band camp or during concert season. Thank you very much.
So as a band kid, I would like to say that our school does not have those things that were on the stands. We have a giant keyboard, like, that the band director just flips a switch and it turns the metronome on. So, but anyway, overall TikTok, I'd probably give it like a 7. I feel like I'm giving 7s too much. You know what? We're gonna be more harsh here. I'll give it a 6, no, 5, 5.5. It's kind of original, not really though. I didn't really find it funny, so I didn't really care for it. But overall, I'll give it a 5.5.
Yes, honey, sign her up. Girl, that ain't it. Girl, where is your body control? Okay, that was better. Girl, you better land it before your mom gets here.
So another TikTok I don't really care for. I mean, I get if you have the right personality, this is kind of funny. You would think that it would be yelling and not telling you advice. You'd think it'd be like, oh, that hurt, you know. But other than that, I mean, it's a pretty original TikTok. It's somewhat funny, not really to me though. I mean, I guess if you did that kind of stuff, I don't, because you know me. I'm anyway. So. Yeah, I give it a 7, maybe an 8. It's pretty original, so. Oh. Oh. Solid 3 out of 10. Boring as hell, and I've seen that trick a million times.
But if the world was ending, you'd come over, right? You'd come over and you'd stay the night. Would you love me for the hell of it? All our fears would be irrelevant if the world was ending. But if...
Okay, well, I doubt that a teacher would react that, like, harshly to someone saying they sucked, because at our school that happens pretty, pretty, pretty often, but maybe that teacher's got, like, something going on that we don't know about. You know, only because I feel bad, but then again, I do think this is staged, but we're gonna go with that it's real, and we'll give it a solid 7, 8. We'll give it an 8. I don't think it's that funny. It's not really funny at all, but I get it. I give it an 8. Animation instant 0 out of 10.
Can I date your daughter?
God, no. No, no, nope.
Why?
I have loftier goals for her than that.
Can I date your daughter?
Okay, one is 5 and one is 3, again, so no.
No, yeah, all right, yeah, that's fair. Can I date your daughter?
No.
Why?
Because my daughter would be your sister. No. <It's->
Can I date your daughter?
Okay, so Alabama 100, just going to put that one out there. It's pretty funny. I can give it... funniness, I give it a 9, or maybe an 8, but... I've seen these all over the place by this one guy, so it's not like it's a repost or anything, so... fairly original from the same person, so... I give it a 7, 8. Yeah, 8 seems reasonable. Okay, she's bald, which means she probably has cancer, which means she'd probably feel bad, but she doesn't have any hair, so that makes it funny, so I'm gonna give it a 9.5.
Boom.
Actually, take that back, it's gonna be an 8.
Boom, ba-da-dum, boom, ba-da-dum, boom, ba-da-dum, boom, ba-da-dum, boom,
say yo, Sean Kingston, you're way too cute.
Boom, ba-da.
I watch hockey, I don't play, but assuming this is accurate, pretty original. I'm not a big fan of the song necessarily, so I'll give it, I feel like I'm giving too many 8 through 6s, but, not 5, because I don't know if this is true or not.
Everybody down, this is a stick up. Hey boss, this old lady isn't getting down. Take her out. My boss, she's just an old lady. I said take her out. I'm having a wonderful time. Sir, what about this kid? Take him out. Wee. Boss, what about this baby? Take him out. I'm the baby. Everybody down.
Okay, so I thought I was gonna pause it on the end, but... you know, I give this one a 10. It's actually pretty funny. Apparently, I think they put a fair amount of effort into it. It's got a fair amount of likes and some shares. Wow, it's got a lot of shares, but, that's actually pretty funny. I like it. It's not crying on the floor, bawling on the floor laughing, but it's, you can get a chuckle out of it if you're having a bad day. So, like, I think I said a 10, 9.5 maybe.
How you doing today?
Good, you?
Not too bad.
Alright, can I get $20 on pump?
What pump are you on, man?
Oh, man, bro, I gotta get to work, man.
Yeah, let me go.
Man, how you, man? You ain't got, man, look, let me get 20 on pump. Oh, shit.
How you doing today?
It's really recorded on a potato, so. But you're gonna be like, you have an Android, so you can't be seen. Okay, shut up. Whatever. I don't care. It's true, though. It really is true. I've been to gas stations, and people are like, yo, let me get $20 on pump. And they have to walk outside, look, and be like, oh, it's 10, you know. But I don't know. I give it a 6. It's not really that original, but it's not very... original, so.
With it. I just made a rolling plane like a landing strip. I'm a 2020 president candidate.
Women can't be presidents. 0 out of 10. No, I'm kidding. Originality, solid one. I give it a solid maybe one or two, maybe just for the effort, time, 30 seconds put into it. And who knows, it could have taken a year and a half to freaking come up with the idea, but I don't know, whatever. It's one or two.
Bang. And that's two, so I'm out.
I'm out of ammo, too.
Okay, so, I give that one, it's above a five. This obviously costs money to make, so I'll give him that one. But, guy seems like a pretty decent dude. He plays airsoft. I mean, you know, I don't always care for airsoft people too much. I don't know. I don't have anything against him. I just don't care for him. But that's a pretty decent TikTok. I give it maybe a 7, 8, maybe 9. We'll give it 8.2. There you go. 8.2. Bam. That's a decent TikTok. I'm just guessing Jaws. Okay, originality, like, well, I saw one earlier at the beginning of the video, but other than that, it's okay. I give it a 5.
Yeah, I'm on the 75, and I think that I might have identified Steve Stevens, the Cleveland shooter.
Okay, sir, how are you able to identify the suspect? Can you describe his skin color, please?
Well, you know, seems to have pretty good skin.
My history. I don't like bringing that up, but if I laugh at that, they're gonna be. It's a repost of a 911 call. I see these a lot. I don't really care. I just think they're kind of just. Oh, look at this really really stupid video I found on YouTube. Let me repost it on TikTok to somewhat get views, and I only get 100 views. So other than that, it's pretty boring. I mean, the call itself is actually pretty dumb, but I honestly thought it was going to be the actual guy calling in. I thought it was going to be, like, Steve Stevens said it was. I don't know, but I give it, like, a 5. I give it a 3.
So we found a new feature in TikTok. You can now search by dancing. Let's test it out. Can you do the Renegade?
Okay, the only part I know is this thing.
Oh, hey, it's working.
Really?
Yeah. Come look. So we found a new feature in TikTok. You can now search.
We gotta try that. Let's see if it's real. Is it real? Oh, wait. Oh, it's a QR code. Okay, so it's not actual dancing.
It's dancing.
That's Photoshop, and their phone's at 3%, and it's an Apple, and it has Renegade in the top, and yeah, no, weird, but pretty decent originality. I'll give it a 5.
Teaching very useful skills, part 1. How to recognize airplane types. If an airplane has this hump in the front and it has 4 engines, it's the 747. Engines are not on the wings, but rather on the back, and there's 3 of them. That's the 727. Here's an easy one for you. If the engines are flat on the bottom, that's the 737. Teaching very useful skills, part 1.
Pretty decent. At least he knows his airplane types. Hopefully, I'm not a big airplane knowledge person, but I guess if you know it, you know it, so. But, yeah, I'd give that one pretty decent. Maybe a 7? Nine out of ten. That reaction is pretty funny. I gotta say that. Now, I'm not a big, you know, I don't. The swastika, I get it. It's not right, but that's just kind of funny. Not promoting Nazism or whatever you want to call it. It's pretty decent, though. I forgot to give a rating. 7. No, did I? 8. I think it's 7. 8.
Now, what kind of mimmy motherfucking foolery is this? They said this goddamn broom was only gonna stand yesterday. Yesterday, cause of gravity. That's some bullshit. This a whole motherfucking new day. And I could dance on around this motherfucker. Dance on around this motherfucker. Whoever came up with that shit need that motherfucking ass kicked. Now, what kind of mimmy?
So, you know, this actually looks like our ISS teacher. So, you know, shout out to her. I doubt she watches this, but in the event she does, whatever. I doubt she would, but yeah, that's actually true. I could actually do it right now, but I'm too lazy to get up out of this chair and go to the garage and get one, even though the garage is right behind me. But I need to finish this video, so it's pretty decent. I give it a 7, maybe, only because I've seen too many videos and I proved this myself, so 7 out of 10.
I'm watching the race. Why wouldn't I be? Hey, one second. Yeah, I think my girl's calling. Just one second.
Yo, it's awesome. Okay. I love some good old NASCAR. I watch it. I don't think I've ever been to one. I think every time they've come here that I've had school or I've been out of town or something. I've never been to one. I want to go to one soon, but, that last part gets me. Sister's girlfriend call. That's pretty good. I'll give this one a solid 10. This is actually pretty funny. I think we'll do about 5 more and then we'll end it on a good one if the 5th one's pretty crappy. So I'll give this one a 10.
If you're a kid and you see a picture of a white cat right there, it means you're privileged as fuck. And you probably get a lot of stuff handed to you. On the other side, if you don't see a white cat and you have no idea what I'm talking about, I'm not talking to you, so you go ahead and have a good day. If you're a kid and
you know, I think that that's a setup because even if you do look at it, it's kind of just like, I don't know, maybe I'd have to go try it on a $5 from the dollar store phone, but, yeah, anyway, that's... Yeah, it's pretty stupid. I don't like it. Maybe it's just because I don't know. You know what? Creativity, and it's not that much of effort, except you slapped a picture of a cat in there. So, 6.
And it went like...
A little bit of Monica in my life. A little bit of Erica by my side. A little bit of Rita's all I need.
Okay, I hate mascot TikToks. They're so stupid, and I hate them. Especially that freaking, who is it? The Indianapolis Colts mascot. Dude, his TikToks are, it's TikToks, I should say. I don't really know what it is, but yeah, no, they're pretty stupid. It's basically just highlights from a fake mascot party that he went to that wasn't even that cool. So, but yeah, 2 out of 10.
I'm flying a fucking jet today. My friend just told me where to wire tomorrow.
Okay, so I kind of want to say that's fake, but I highly doubt it is. But, you know, that's a pretty decent TikTok. The guy seemed pretty weird. I don't know what he was talking about wiring money, but, I'd give it a 9. Originality is pretty, you don't really see that all day, but those jets are shit, dude. Alright, this next one will be our last one before, unless it's really bad.
Perfect face check.
My heart just got stuck between these loops. Between these loops. My mind got stuck in between these groups. Groups, huh?
Perfect face.
Okay, this one was shit, so we're gonna go again. But, no, I'm gonna be a little bit of a person real quick, and every face is perfect, so. Yeah, but. Yeah, I guess that's just perfect proportioned face, not really. But, well, I don't really care. Effort to probably, I don't know, I'll give a 4.
Alright guys, Fortnite chat.
Fortnite, it's ass. 0 out of 10. It had Guy Fieri in it. 9 out of 10. And the only reason it's not 10 is because I hate the fucking Raiders. And Ice Cube is pretty cool, and I don't even know who the rest of the people were, so... We'll do one extra TikTok from my follow page, and hopefully I didn't fall asleep on TikTok and follow somebody weird. So here we go.
Rest in peace to Pop Smoke. My condolences go out to his friends and his family, everyone being hurt from this situation. And being from Brooklyn, New York, and all New Yorkers in general, this shit just hurts. This hurts on a different level, man. Pop Smoke was bringing a name to the drill rap scene in New York City. He was going to change the game for all these drill rappers out here in New York City. I was really expecting that Bobby Shmurda 6ix9ine Pop Smoke collab, but that's not going to happen now. But for real, rest in peace, Pop Smoke. Rest in paradise. We all love you down here. And I'm happy that in New York City right now, it's a sunny day. He's shining the light on us New Yorkers. Rest in peace, Pop Smoke. Rest.
Who the fuck is Pop Smoke? So we'll just end it on that note. I don't know who Pop Smoke is, but you know what, whoever he is, rest in peace. I don't know who the hell he is, but apparently some rapper. But I'll give it a 7 out of 10. That guy's pretty funny. If you see some of his videos like at late at night, you die at him. But okay, so I guess overall my TikTok day, for this section, I guess you could call it, I don't really know. I give it like maybe a solid 6 for overall. But anyway, if you like the video and you want part 2, slap the like button, comment, do whatever, you know. Anyway, see you in the next video. Bye.